Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nitcher, a retired lecturer in mythology, teaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I want to tell you that people who talk about sin in the churches, especially the doctoral people and others, they are antichrist and they are blasphemers. In Jesus, you know, we have nothing to do with sin, because sin is transgression against the moral laws, and moral laws are made to train or tame the natural man how to behave. So the natural man is, as you can see, the firstborn of nature, or the once-born person, who only can understand things of the flesh, not of spirit. That means he can't perceive. So when he understands the things of spirit, when he understands the things of flesh and not of spirit, then he's not sensible enough, because the things of the spirit are understood by the sensible people, not by the once-born simpletons. So the natural person, you know, was taken to the rabbi to teach him the moral laws of Moses so that he can behave in the society. So the rabbis, Pharisee, Sadducee, and John the Baptist, they were all moral teachers, and they used to have disciples. And that's what Jesus, when he was eating at Matthew's place, some Pharisee, Sadducee came, "Hey, your disciples," they called them disciples, you know, but they were laborers. "Your disciples, you know, they don't wash their hand or say prayer and fasting and those of the John the Baptist do, and Pharisees, Sadducees." Then Jesus said, "So far the Christ is in their heart, they don't need to." Christ can come in your heart if you are twice born. If you are once born, then you cannot know Christ. You are honest and all that is good, you know, but to preach gospel, to understand what is happening, you need Christ. Christ is the wetting stone to wet everything, to judge. So if you are not capable of judging, then you are a blind person. So these people, soon after the church was established, then remember that the Messianic Jews, they occupied the church by the end of the first century. And when they occupied it, they bring in their Torah, Old Testament, and people over there, they were made drunk with the old wine of the letters. Apostle used to come and they rebuked the bishop, you know, or administrator of the church, "What the hell you are doing, making them drunk with the old wine of the letters, desiring not the new?" But the bishop retorted, you know, "Look, they are happy. They don't need you. Get out of my church or do what I tell you." So they expelled the apostles out of their churches. And that's why the apostles then opened monasteries. But as soon as Roman was under their grip, Emperor Constantine especially, when he came under their grip, you know, because he wanted soldiers and they wanted favor, you know, the church people, because the monks were criticizing them. So they put the monks before animals to be eaten alive. light came among his own, and his own loved darkness, and they killed the apostles. And now you have the fulfilling of Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45. The arid temple, the arid spirit of the temple priests who were sacked from the wine press, the temple husbandmen's, because they were no good for any other job. So they said, oh, let's go back to our old customers. And they entered the church of God and occupied it with Torah under their armpit. So it's the Torah, you know, which has the sin and all that to train the natural man. So that's how they propagated or gave more importance to sin than to gospel, because gospel they could not do. Gospel lied with the apostles, which they have killed. So there was no light. So its darkness is carrying on, you know. And today also the darkness. These apostles, these docular priests, they happily talk about sin. Sin are committed by the once born, ignorant men who are not familiar with the, who are not sensible enough to know what is right and what is wrong. So they commit sin, you know. That's why in John 9, when Jesus was saying that these are blind guides of the blind, then one of the Pharisees said, ah, do you call me a blind person? Then Jesus said, now you know that you are not blind. Then if you do wrong, then you are committing more serious sin called blasphemy, hypocrisy. And that's why Jesus condemned hypocrisy the most. You hypocrite. And he said so many things to them, you know. What you do, you know, widows, property you snatch and all that, you know, that is what's happening today. Church of England is rich. The other churches are rich because they get the widow's property. In one of the church I attended, they, oh, we are getting short of the funds because not many people are dying, and also the widows are not donating to the their property to the church before they used to. So these people who are docile people, they are Judas Iscariot in sheep's clothing. At the end of the month, they put their hand into the church purse, which is the donation given by the congregation. Same as people used to give donation to Jesus, and Judas Iscariot used to carry the purse, and he would dip his hand into the purse to steal. He was a thief. And that is why he was thrown out of the company of the other 12 at the Last Supper, when everything was clear to everyone, the other one, except Peter, because he was once born. Once born people cannot detect these things. So here is something I've written. Sins were applicable to the natural ignorant person, as Jesus told the Pharisee in John 9, who questioned him, do you think I am blind? This person was not ignorant, and he was subject to blasphemy or hypocrisy, as we have today these hireling dog-collared priests in the synagogues of Satan, these churches, you know, organized churches. That is fulfilling Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45. In Jesus, we are royal priests and we have fellowship, and not these organized churches of the old type. Same as the temple high priest is replaced by Pope and so and so. This is the golden age of Christ, a chance for resurrection. Resurrection you get when you preach gospel. Then you are the son of the Most High. You cannot be son of the Most High if you go to the church and say prayer. Prayers are said to alienated Yahweh and not to our Father. Our Father is in your heart and he is not deaf and dumb. So the resurrection and the once-born disciples are good for nothing to understand gospel that is meant for the twice-born spiritual peoples, spiritual, sensible people. These priests in the churches, they are sensible, they know what they are doing. But they hypocritically carry on because they get money. Priestly profession is the number one profession according to the survey by Telegraph. They are more satisfied, more happy. They stood number one, you know, among the professions. So you can see how comfortably they are sitting in their chairs. And they don't want to leave it. So sin is left to the hypocrite, antichrist, to lure their victims into the churches where prayers are conducted as if our Father Emmanuel, our Father is inside, and this is the temple of God, is inside, is deaf and dumb like the Old Testament demi-urge Yahweh, whose son was Jesus, Yeshua. Yeshua was the son. This big physical body is concerned with Yahweh. Unless you are son of Yahweh, you cannot be son of the real Father, God, which is Spirit. So demiurge means that is like, you know, you make a brick. This house is made of brick which is fired, you know. But before it is fired, is it called green or raw brick, which is then subject to the kiln to be fired and made hard to wear, to take up the rain and everything. Same, you know, your faith. When you are a natural person, then your faith is green. It's raw, it's not firm. When you become twice born, then you put it under the kiln of His word. Remember Jesus said, I have bring fire. This fire is holy fire in which we subject ourselves to be burnt so that we are no more raw brick, but we become baked brick, which is everlasting. So that is how, you know, when you become twice born, when you preach gospel, then we know that you are baked brick. And then you attain resurrection, then you are the son of the Most High, like Father, like Son. Our Father God blesses you. Everything is so simple and clear, you know. But you just let your spirit speak. Don't crush it. You know in your heart. But you are not confident, you know. Unless you open your mouth, and more you preach gospel, more is given by our Father to you. If you keep your mouth shut, what is given to you is taken away. So you must be, don't be frightened of anyone. So far, your thinking is logical, because logical reasoning bring you logo. Logos is His word that settles in your heart. Then you know it is His word, because many people, you know, when I started, you know, then I was doubting what I'm saying, whether it's His word or not. Because I did not know, you know, not sure. But when I start thinking logically, then I know, oh, this is his word, you know. Then you see how happy you will feel. So it's up to you, you know, to preach gospel. We are like sower, you know, sower sowing the seed of his word in your heart. It's up to you to grow it. We can't grow it. We can just water it. Water mean we can answer question, you know, relating to your any doubts. But it is up to you to put it into practice and you to grow it. So don't talk about sin in the regime of Jesus. Sin is the regime of Moses or John the Baptist. Our Father God blesses you.